Hello everyone, welcome to Andy Visits. In today's video, we'll be discussing 5 times Filmmakers brought back dead actors through CGI. With 3D cinemas going mainstream across the world early on, filmmakers have clearly pushed the bill to make the movie-going experience more immersive than ever. But there is one trend this decade that brings some serious creative, legal, and even ethical challenges in its wake. As tech gets closer and closer to reality, the resurrections of Hollywood stars after they have passed away. Carrie Fisher, Star Wars: Rise of Skywalker. After Fisher's sudden passing away at the age of 60, director J.J. Abrams was forced to alter the final Star Wars script and work with unused footage from the last Jedi's principal shooting. The result was a shockingly accurate reproduction of the actor, which several fans were emotional and overjoyed to see, giving her a fitting farewell after over 40 years of being the galaxy's favorite warrior princess. Paul Walker, Furious 7. This might just be one that started them all. If we think back to 2015, after Walker tragically died in a car accident back in 2013, his brother stepped in, along with others, to use a combination of CGI and motion tracking to revive the fan favorite for one last ride, leading to what just might be the most emotional scenes in a series usually famous for high-speed racing and fight sequences. Seymour Hoffman, The Hunger Games: Mockingjay Part 2. One of the most talented performances within the Hunger Games franchise, Hoffman's death midway through second film posed a series of challenges for director Francis Lawrence, who wanted to keep the Academy Award-winning actor in the film without the use of CGI. The answer? A bit of clever, discreet script tailoring and camera placement. Brandon Lee, The Crow. Probably one of the oldest examples of CGI resurrections on this list, it receives a special mention for being one of the most tragic yet interesting stories in the Hollywood stunt trade. Brandon Lee, son of Bruce Lee, was shot nearly point blank with a .44 Magnum due to a fatal mistake from the film's special effects team. In desperation to save the film, the director cast Lee's stunt double for several of the film's remaining shoots. That same stuntman is Chad Stahelski, the man behind now famous John Wick series. Peter Cushing, Rogue One, A Star Wars Story. In yet another Star Wars resurrection, this time the dark side would have one of its most iconic villains brought back to life, Grand Moff Tarkin. Originally played by veteran British actor Peter Cushing, the character was revived through the efforts of yet another BBC and British theatre stalwart, Guy Henry, over 20 years after the former passed away.